Hello, my name is Drew Montell, and welcome to the Ernie Ball Music Man Factory here in San Luis Obispo, where we make all of our electric guitars and basses. Starting here today in our factory that was built in 1997, that was specifically built for all of our manufacturing purposes. Behind me you can see this is where everything begins. Everything comes through this door here. As far as all the raw wood, we have all different kinds of wood, from mahogany to rosewood, basswood, ash, alder, maple, you name it, we've got it, all the cool tone woods. Here you can see we have a variety of woods that we've brought in plank form, that we fabricate down into what we need to do to put everything on our machines to get things moving. Here's where we glue together all of our body blanks, where we take the prepped wood, clamp them up, glue them nice and tight. We size them and weigh them and get them ready for all of our different body styles. From our planks of wood, we fabricate these body blanks for all of our different shapes and sizes for our basses and guitars. You can see we have a variety of wood, from swamp ash to poplar to mahogany, in 1, 2, and 3-piece bodies. All of these bodies are pretty much ready to be put on our machine once they're bandsawed into their body shapes. This is our CNC machine, where we take all of our body blanks and start milling them for our bodies. In this case, we have some 25th anniversary models getting milled for our binding channel. All right, here we have our epoxy pouring station, where we apply our binding to our instruments. In this particular case, it's a 25th anniversary guitar. As you can see, there's some special taping up that's necessary to get our three-dimensional binding. It's kind of a unique thing for us, the way we do this. We don't use traditional binding strips. We have a specially formulated epoxy that allows us to do it in this manner, which gives us a little more freedom to do a variety of body shapes in a much more efficient time. Here we have one of our CNC machines that's fabricating one of our Stingray 5 bodies. As you can see, we've got a blank here that has been bandsawed out to the generic body shape. All of our bodies are modeled in 3D in our CAD/CAM software, where we've engineered to create these programs, each one unique for all of our different options. It goes onto the machine. It takes about anywhere between 10 and 12 minutes to run the body, and we finish up with a finished body that takes a couple of second operations and is off to sanding. Here we have our tone block gluing station. The tone block came about with our Silhouette 20th anniversary model, when we started developing what we call our kind of our tone wood cocktail. And what we've got here is a couple of body blanks that have been milled out so we can insert our mahogany tone block. And what we have here is, once the tone block is glued in, we take a variety of different woods, some for aesthetics, but mostly for functionality and for tone. This in particular is a quilt maple, which we will then sandwich over the top of all of this and vacuum seal the top on the body so that everything is capped. And that will be our final body blank before we make, in this particular case, our John Petrucci BFR model. This is where we keep all of our select tops for our different bodies. Mainly our BFRs, but also our Axis models and some of our anniversary models as well. As you can see, we have a variety of maples. We also have spalted maple and koa. Depending on the model, we put a variety of different tone woods together. In this case, we have these three woods that we kind of focus on for the most part. And we only select the highest grades of tops. We don't let tops go through the system unless they have high quality figure. All of our tops are seamlessly bookmatched to make sure that we have the finest quality aesthetics on the bodies themselves. Here's some maple that has been cut down, ready to get trimmed down to one of our sterling necks. Here we have some of our rosewood fretboard blanks. And one of our newer additions, one of our blanks for a full rosewood neck. This is how we have to start to fit everything onto our custom tooling that we make for all of our individual models. We also have our mahogany neck blanks for our BFR line. Here we have our next staging area where we let all of our neck blanks and fingerboards acclimate to our manufacturing environment, where we end up getting it stable so that we can maintain our plus or minus 10 thousandths tolerance on all of our fabrication here in the wood shop. I've got three necks here. It kind of shows the variety of necks we do for guitars. We have our bird's eye maple. We have a special run here of our flame maple. And we also have our mahogany necks. All of our necks have been kiln dried to make sure for the stable environment of manufacturing. Everything in our machine shop and wood shop here have a tolerance of plus or minus 10,000, so we have the tightest tolerance for the highest quality control for all of our instruments. You can see from the neck blank here, they get ready to go to be put on the machine here, which has custom tooling and custom programs to manufacture all of our unique instruments. As you can see here, we've got a neck that's ready to have the side dots and face dots put in it. It's all done by hand. Here we have our neck carve machine, where it's all set up to manufacture and mill all of our different neck carves. We're known for our necks for the playability with regards to the finish and how comfortable they are. So you can see here we've got a neck that's before and after it's been on this machine. Here we have two custom-made machines specifically for this purpose of putting the radius on the fingerboard as well as fret sawing. We have a variety of what we call swinger arms, which we put on different radiuses for all of our necks. The stations are set up as a bass swinger and setup and a guitar swinger and setup. All the necks are swung to have a precise radius as well as a thickness, and all of the fret saws are calibrated and swung at one time to make sure we have perfect intonation across the entire fingerboard. Here we have our automatic fret press machine where we install all of our different scale lengths of frets. The machine's set up to have a very precise and accurate pressure so that all of our frets are level and they sit flat on the fingerboard. And now you have your finished Music Man neck. Here, for example, we've got our Stealth John Petrucci model and a Ball Family Reserve 12-string mahogany neck for Joe Bonamassa. All right, welcome to our sanding department. Here we start to kind of take off some of the machine marks that are left from our CNC machines. You can see here we're starting the prep sanding for our current JP mahogany BFR necks. Here we have one of our final sanding stations for our necks where we go over all the fine details before we put our oil and wax and or finish over the back end of the necks here. As you can see, there's a lot of skill that's required here because, as I told you earlier, we keep a very tight tolerance in our machine shop or in our wood shop, and therefore we have to make sure that everybody here is trained and has a very keen eye for detail to make sure that they maintain that quality control and that integrity in our instruments. Here we have a couple of necks that have been final sanded and they're ready to be taken into finishing where they'll get the headstocks, whether they're matching or not, as well as all of the silkscreen and top coat. Here we have some of our final body sanding stations where they go over every last detail of the instruments. Again, just like the necks, straight off the machine, there's still some machine marks, but we have a very tight tolerance for quality control. Everybody here is very finely trained and in tune with what our quality levels are, and they make sure every last little detail is sanded out before we move on to the finishing department.